when you're independent, you've finally decided to quit the 9-to-5, to become, you know, to stop whatever you were doing, to form a career, and you're going to be an independent insurance adjuster. And that word independent switches your thinking a little bit. Now, when you're coming from a stable job, it can be difficult to understand that you're not guaranteed money in this. If you're going to take your independent adjuster license and you're going to get a job at State Farm or a job with some insurance company where you're going to be collecting that salary, then it doesn't matter so much. But when you're an independent, you need to understand that you're not an employee anymore. You're not going to get a consistent flow of income from your employer. You need to look for more than one company to work with. That is where your business comes from. And it is a business. That's what a lot of the employees think differently. So to go back to the example with the wedding photographer, a wedding typically, that wedding only happens one time. So after every wedding is over, that wedding photographer has to go find another new client. If they don't find a new client, then they're not going to make any money. Then they're going to have to go back to bartending or whatever they were doing before. So when you're an independent insurance adjuster, what you need to understand at the very get is that you need to think like that. This is not a game where you say, oh, who's hiring? If you ask the question, who's hiring, you've already lost, because that's the wrong question to ask. The real question to ask is who's paying? Because if it's somebody that is paying for a service that you provide, then that company should be a company worth your interest. And you shouldn't be thinking about individual companies either. You need to be thinking about a large network of companies, and that's exactly what you need. So you're new to adjusting, you just got in. Your number one, the number one task that you need to have from the very beginning, because understand, you've already got your license. If you're living in California, you've already got your California state license. You can legally adjust claims in that state, whether it's Texas, Florida. If you're in a non-licensing state, you should get a license anyway, just to show that you have that level of competency, that you understand what insurance is, what a claims adjusting is, you understand all this stuff. But no matter what, you have the legal ability to adjust insurance claims in your state. What comes after that, and always comes after that, is marketing. Now, the reason I say this is because so many people that get involved in this, they get it wrong. They don't think marketing, because marketing is a business term, right? You don't do marketing when you're an employee. So many people think like an employee, and that's the problem. So you need to begin to market yourself. So what is it? What does that mean? What does it mean to market yourself? If you've come from a business background, if you had your own business before becoming an independent adjuster, this might not seem as foreign to you. But for employees, it's different. So when you're an employee, you kind of do market yourself in a way, but you may not recognize it. When you go out to the mall, you're going to get a job at the mall. You go there with your resume, right? You're 16, 17, 18 years old. You're going to get a job at the mall. Maybe you're going to get a job at Auntie Anne's. Maybe you're going to get a job at the movie theater. But you go there, and you go there to fill out applications. You're going to go to each store. You're going to say hello. Maybe you meet the manager. And then you're going to ask them for an application. You fill out the application. You hand it back. That is the simplest. That example right there is the simplest form of just old school marketing. You are putting your name and information, you're putting your likeness out there to other people. And you're filling out that application, which that application could be considered in a way an advertisement for you. You're advertising yourself to this potential employer, but you're doing so inside the confines of an application. What you want is for that potential employer to read your application. And even though they read 9 other applications before that, they're going to choose your application. And that's maybe why you lied a little bit on the work history. Because that document is a piece of marketing material. And you are marketing yourself to whatever business, whatever store you drop that resume off to. Now, it's no different. We still need to get our names, our contact information, our likeness, all that sort of stuff in front of people that will potentially pay us. And that's what you need to understand. It's the same thing. It's just a little bit different than what most people get because we're not looking for just one employer. We need several of them. And that's how you be very successful is when you have a large number of potential clients routinely coming to you to see if you're available for some work because they know that you provide a good service and they want the best service for the for the insurance companies that that independent adjusting firm works with. So you need to market. Now the biggest thing that new adjusters think is that it's going to be impossible for them to find work if they're new. That's the biggest thing. And it's not just independent adjusters. I don't want it to sound like that because it's every industry. It's every industry, and it's not a mystery why. It's every industry. The one big thing that new adjusters, anybody that's new to a field, you've got a college degree. How can I get experience if the companies that are looking for what I'm doing are only accepting people who already have experience? How are you going to get a job if you have no experience and all the companies want people that have experience? How could you ever get into it? So then the second thought that usually comes after that is, hey, what companies are taking on brand new people? So there are companies that will take on brand new people, for sure. Doesn't happen often. But the reason why I bring that up is because I would like everyone to just for a moment take the perspective, consider their perspective of a company, like an independent insurance adjusting company, a claims company. Put yourself in their shoes for a moment, okay? You have a staffing problem. Your staffing problem is that you need someone in a particular area. You need several people in a particular area. Let's say it's my area, the Northeast United States. You need staff there. You need boots on the ground. You need people that are going to help you because you just landed. This is a small company. It's your own company. You just landed an account in the Northeast, which means your business is going to be bringing in more money. Okay? But you need to service that client. If you can't service that new client the way that they're expecting you to service them, they're going to find somebody else. Now you can't get out there. You aren't the boots on the ground. You're not going to facilitate the work. You're going to need to find personnel in that area so that they can properly satisfy your client and that your client will continue to give business to you and your business will continue to succeed. Now, putting yourself in the shoes of that person, what would you do? You probably would put up help wanted ads, right? You'd put up, what do you go on, ZipRecruiter? Let me ask you a question. What would you say if I gave you three words that you can add to that post, to that job listing, that will immediately thin out the people who have never actually done what you're looking for done? In other words, what if I gave you three words that would immediately, inherently raise the quality of the applicants that are coming through your ad? Would you take that offer? Would you ask me to share that with you, those three words? Of course you would. You mean to add three words and the applicants are better? Hell yeah. Of course you're going to want that. Here are those three words. Experience is required. That's it. You put experience in is required. Three words takes you a fraction, takes you what? 2-3 seconds to put that in your job post. Immediately your applicants become better because you're only getting applicants with experience.